Sucrose has somehow become one of the most underrated and also one of the best kept secrets to doing big burst damage in Genshin Impact. I'm sure you guys have seen the videos out there floating around the internet of the 1 million damage Mona bursts, or the Diluc damage, or the Klee damage, or any of this other stuff out there. And part of that secret is Sucrose. And we're going to go over exactly why you should be using her if this is the strategy that you're going to be trying to use in Genshin Impact. We're going to go over everything you need to know from gear as to why it works and what you guys need to be doing, because it's no coincidence that she's always in the lab brewing up some specialties. So let's talk about Sucrose. And thankfully, none of the stuff that you need has anything to do with her constellations. Her constellations can help you do it more often, but the stuff that you need is all very free-to-play friendly, all very accessible, and it only comes from the talents you gain from your ascension levels up. So let's talk about her base talents real quick. Obviously, she's got her base attack, Anemo damage, all that good stuff. She's the Anemo character. And yeah, you guys probably already know what sort of artifact set she's going to be using. Then we have her elemental skill. Anemo damage groups things together. It's going to help you do the big burst damage, and it's going to have that very important Anemo damage type. Also, her elemental burst, same thing. Going to group up people again, do Anemo damage so you can proc that swirl effect, and this is where it's coming from. It also has the elemental absorption effect. This can help you out if you have the higher constellations, but you do not need it for the big damage. Now, the big ones that we need to be talking about is catalyst conversion. We're going to break it all down, very easy for you guys to understand and follow. So catalyst conversion here: when Sucrose triggers the swirl effect, characters in the party with the matching element have their elemental master increased by 50 for 8 seconds. Before we break that down, the next one is very similar. When she uses either her elemental skill or her elemental burst and it hits an enemy, it increases all of your other party members' masteries to the elements, elemental mastery, by 20% of whatever Sucrose's elemental mastery is for 8 seconds. And this is what we're really talking about here. This is why she's the secret and one of the best kept secrets so far in Genshin Impact for you guys when we're talking about big burst damage. Now, why is this? What does elemental mastery actually do? So if you go and check out elemental mastery as a stat, we've gone over this. If you want the full breakdown on how every stat in the game works, there's a video on the channel for that already for you guys. But what it does here is it increases your elemental damage reactions. Now, you're going to notice that there's going to be two of these elemental reactions that are set apart from the other ones. This is Vaporize and Melt. They get a lower damage increase than Overload, Superconduct, Electrocharged, Shattered, and Swirl. Those get the biggest of the two. You get about roughly half of the benefit on Vaporize and Melt. But even though you're getting half the benefit on those are the two that we're looking for when it comes to the sort of team compositions we want to be making to utilize these big elemental mastery buffs on Sucrose. Now, why is that? This is because the other ones, Overload, Superconduct, Electrocharge, all of those different elemental reactions, they only scale off of two things, your character level and your elemental mastery. That's why they get a larger buff, because there's not a whole lot going into increasing how much damage you're doing with these. There's only two stats the game cares about. But the other ones, Vaporize and Melt, these work in a vastly different way. And this is going to increase your damage by a whole lot, because even though this multiplier increase is smaller, there's a lot more going into the effect of the base damage of Vaporize and Melt than the other ones. This is because of the way that Vaporize and Melt work, and these, if you don't know, are the Pyro and Hydro elemental combinations, or the Pyro and Cryo elemental combinations. This is because TLDR, basically the way they work, is say you're using a Pyro character, you've already afflicted the enemy with, you know, a cryo attack or a hydro attack, so they have the little elemental symbol on them already. When you go to hit with your pyro damage, the game will look at how much you're hitting that enemy for. Say you score a critical hit, you have very high critical hit damage, you have very high attack, you have very high pyro elemental damage. It's going to say, I'm about to hit this guy for a lot of damage. And what it's going to do, it's going to take that and multiply it. Now, the fire ones that you get, so if you proc it with fire or on the water ones, or you proc it with fire on the cryo ones, it's going to give you a 150% damage modifier to your skill. So if you're going to hit it for 100k, you hit it for 150k. Now, the other way also works, and they do actually get a higher multiplier. So if you are going to, say, have an enemy already afflicted with pyro, and then you hit it with a cryo skill or a hydro skill, it's going to be a 200% multiplier. So you're going to hit it for even harder than before. Now, this 15% that you see here in this case with this 80 elemental mastery, That is then calculated on top of that to increase your damage by an even larger amount. So you can see just how powerful this can be with Sucrose. Say you build her for straight elemental mastery, which is what you're going to want to be doing in this situation. Build her for nothing but elemental mastery. This allows you to build your other character, whether it's a pyro character or a cryo character or a hydro character, whoever is going to be proccing and wanting that big damage bonus from the Sucrose elemental mastery. You can just, if you want to, disregard almost all elemental mastery, right? Build them for attack percent, crit hit chance, crit hit damage, the respective elementals. So if you're working on a pyro character, you build them for pyro damage. This allows you to get really greedy. And then on top of all of that stats, because you only get so many stats on each piece of gear, right? You can only get one stat upgrade per time. Focus all of it into just all the raw attack percent, crit hit chance, crit hit damage, elemental damage increase. And then Sucrose can wear all of that elemental mastery gear, wear all of that energy recharge gear. She has faster access to her elemental burst here. And then you're going to be getting a bunch of free elemental mastery on top of that, right? Instead of having 40 elemental mastery to go with all that attack percent, crit chance, crit damage percent, elemental damage percent, you then will group them up, hit them with swirl, and get the elemental mastery bonus, the 50 here, as well as this one here. So if say you get her to 1,000 elemental mastery, which isn't going to happen, but that's a nice round even number. If you get her to 1,000 elemental mastery, she's going to give everyone else 200 plus this one as well, so 250. If you get her to 500 elemental mastery, then she's going to give everyone 100 in addition to this, so 150 free elemental mastery. You can do a lot of crazy things with some RNG with that as well with her gear setup. But on top of that, you have the artifacts and the weapons. Let's talk about those real fast for you guys here. So there's going to be two sets of artifacts. They're going to be pretty powerful for her. The mainstay one is going to be the Viridescent Venomer set still. Now this one, you guys have heard about it, I'm sure. This is for the four-piece bonus. It decreases the opponent's elemental resistance by 40% if you are matching the element that you are swirling. So say I want to increase my pyro damage. I hit the enemy with a pyro effect. I will then hit them with a swirl effect from Sucrose. This will trigger swirl, so it'll set off her two ascensions, so elemental mastery for everybody, especially the one for the pyro character, and then it's gonna reduce the enemy's resistance to pyro damage by 40%. If it goes in the negatives, you get half the benefit. So if the enemy has 10% pyro resist, it's gonna take it down by 10, then it's at zero, and then you have 30% more to go. That is now halved, so it's gonna go down to negative 15%. So you're gonna be increasing your damage by quite a lot still with just this set, and then the elemental mastery, and you'll be good to go there, ready to set up your swirl into your vaporize or melt combo attack. Almost got all the names wrong there, but we pulled it out in the end. Now, that's not the only set you can use. That's the best set, but another set that you can use here for her is going to be the instructor set. Now, this is because it's going to increase her elemental mastery on top of that by a little bit, and then it's going to also, it is bugged in the game right now. This is not the correct phrasing, but it says after using an elemental skill, increases all party members' elemental mastery by 120 for 8 seconds. That's incorrect. It's after performing an elemental reaction, which is what you're doing already. Swirl is the elemental reaction here. So even though it's wrong in game, that description there, it's still going to be working for this situation. So elemental mastery for everyone there, elemental mastery for herself, which feeds into 20% of her own elemental mastery. So this is also a very fantastic set for her. And obviously with this sort of Sucrose support style aspect, you're focusing on two stats mainly, elemental mastery and energy recharge. Energy recharge is going to help you get back your elemental burst a little bit faster. And that's going to be very important, especially if you have low to no constellations on Sucrose, because even though you can do this with no constellations whatsoever, she does have a pretty lengthy cooldown on her elemental skill. So if you can build up how fast you get your elemental burst back, that's going to just give you more swirl reactions because you're having more chances to use your elemental burst. More damage, more burst. It's going to be a good time out there. Now, this doesn't not need to be used with Klee and with Diluc, you know, and with Mona. You can use them as long as you're using the correct elements. You can use this Sucrose combination for your team there. So there's a lot of cool stuff you can do there. And as far as weapons go, there's really two. There's kind of a third cheesy one we'll talk about, but there's three. The easiest access one to get is Thrilling Tales of the Dragon Slayers. This is because the refinement on this one is fairly easy to use. It gives her a little bit of base HP, so going to help her out, but she doesn't really need it. But the main thing we're looking for here is refinement rank 5, legacy. When switching characters, the new character taking the field has their attack increased by 48% for 10 seconds. Now, attack is not the end-all be-all stat in this game, but the more attack you have, the more crit hit chance you have on your other character doing the damage, the better the elemental mastery buff's going to be. The more attack you have, the better their character's crit chance and crit damage are going to be. So this is going to give your new character that swaps into the field with all your big daddy weapons and levels and all their skills leveled up, it's going to give them increased attack percent. Now this is going to help the build overall. It doesn't help her with her elemental mastery, but it's going to be an easy way to get a large buff on a character during that burst window, right? This lasts 10 seconds. Her elemental mastery buffs last 8 seconds. So you can have a lot of quick swapping in and out. And this also will help you during the downtime. If you're just swapping into her real quick, you can swap right back into your damage dealing character periodically every 20 seconds. So you can get that working for you there. Now, the other ones you can use, all right, is the Mappa Mare. Now, let's talk about the Mappa Mare. The Mappa Mare is a crafted book that you can get. And the only reason you're going to be wanting this book is simply for the stat that it has on it. And you're right, it's got elemental mastery on it. Now, it does have a proc here where it increases your elemental damage bonus. Your Sucrose in this sort of setup is not really there to do damage. She will be doing swirl damage for sure, so this could help her out. If you want to go all in and build the best Sucrose you can to make her do damage too, you can do that. You can do crit hit chance, crit hit damage, attack percent, elemental mastery on top of everything. That's going to be some insanely god tier gear to get all that rolling. But if you want to do the big burst damage for your character, the ones that you see out there, you don't need all of that stuff, but you still kind of want some elemental mastery, so this book's works for you as well. Now, the last one is the cheese book, and this is one that I'm going to mention because I know if I don't, someone else is going to mention it because you can use it for this reason. Now, this is the Widsith book. Now, the Widsith book, 33% of the time, it's going to be insane for this strategy. The other 66.666% of the time, it's going to do nothing for this strategy. So this is because the way that this book works is when you swap into the battlefield, the character who has the Widsith on, it's like the reverse of the Dragon Slaying book. So this is going to give Sucrose a buff. Now Sucrose is going to get a 10 second buff, and this is going to give her either an attack percent buff, an elemental damage buff, or an elemental mastery buff. So this was going to give you perhaps up to, I think it's like 450 elemental mastery if you manage to get it to refinement rank 5. But that's only 33% of the time because there's 3 different buffs and they have the same odds of proccing when you swap her in. Now, if you do, at the end of the day, have that god tier build where she's got all the crit hit chance, crit hit damage, attack percent, all of that stuff, and you can make her do damage in her own right, then all of these buffs will be good for you because she's going to be doing a little bit more damage because of the giant attack buff or the giant elemental damage buff. And if you get the elemental mastery buff too, good for you there. So that's going to be the weapons for Sucrose, the books to be looking at, the artifacts to be looking at. If you do happen to have her constellations, you don't need them, but the ones that do help a lot, the first one gets you an extra charge on your elemental skill. So if you get this one, it's going to allow you to just do this elemental combination reaction thing a lot more often, right? You just get 2 uses. It's normally a very lengthy cooldown. I think it's like a 15-second cooldown. Now you have 2 different 15-second cooldowns that you can use at your leisure there. And the last one here, if you get this one, it's just going to give you more damage for those characters. It's basically nothing you need to learn how to play around. It's doing everything that you're already doing. The way that this works is when you use your Forbidden Creation Isomer 75 Type 2, the character that matches the swirl or the elemental absorption, I should say, in this regard. So say you use her elemental burst on a character that's got the fire debuff, the pyro debuff, it's going to cause a pyro swirl, and it's also going to turn into a fire elemental burst on top of that. And so on top of everyone that's a pyro character getting that elemental mastery increase based off of your elemental mastery increase, on top of that, if you're wearing the Viridis and Venra set doing the fire resist down, which you're already trying to do, on top of all of that stuff, all your pyro characters are going to be getting a 20% elemental damage bonus for themselves on top of that. So it's just more damage, but it's 20% more. It's pretty cool, it's pretty significant, but it doesn't make or break the build. So this is available for everyone, free to play, whoever it is that wants to utilize a Sucrose. Now, with that being said, I'm going to go ahead. We're going to show you just how to do it in game, because you can see the videos, you can watch the videos, but you may not know what's going on. So you want to be able to know how to use something like this. So now that you've seen all of the behind the scenes action and how to set up the character, it's gonna be a little bit of demonstration on how you go about through doing the elemental combo. You're not gonna see the giant burst here. Remember, Asuka's level 1 on this account, level 4 maybe, whatever. She doesn't have all the essentials. She doesn't have the gear to really make the build come together, but this is gonna show you how to do it in action. You're gonna do a couple things in order. You wanna apply Pyro, then you're gonna swap to Sucrose, you're gonna do the Swirl, then you're gonna swap to your Cryo slash Hydro character, hit them with the Cryo slash Hydro move. This is gonna set them up for you to be ready to do the Vaporize slash Melt. Then you're gonna swap back into your main damage dealer that wants to do all that big damage and hit them with your skill. So a little bit of a 1, 2, 3, 4, swaps in there. 3 swaps to get back to your other character. So that's pretty much what we're going to do here. Let's see if we can do this stuff right here. Hopefully they don't walk into the water or anything. So just pyro that guy, a little bit of that, and then boom, ready to go. So we're going to set him up, ready to rock and roll. A little bit of melt action, a little bit of a casual little mini bot for 9k. We don't have all of the stuff. That's just a base effect of melt basically doing its job there for you. So see if we can set this guy up too as well once again, and then boom, a little bit of melt action, but nothing super crazy. But you are going to be able to do insane stuff if you work on a build like this. If that's something that you want to have, is a strong support character that can increase your damage by a ton through her elemental mastery buff, as you've seen in a lot of the high-end stuff. And this is something that you could work on for one of your supports in that last team composition, then that's something that you should be doing. So that being said, guys, hopefully you found this informative. Sucrose is a very well-kept secret for these burst damage team compositions. You can use her in other ways, but we're talking about that super secret burst team composition way. There's some other ones we need to be talking about there. Bennett is actually pretty strong as well. A lot of you guys have been sleeping on him too, so we're going to be going over him hopefully soon in the future on top of that. So if you want to see more stuff like this for Genshin Impact, cool strategies, etc., you know what to do. Until then, guys, stay safe, have fun out there, and I'll see you guys in the next one.